Not really, because the U.S. economy's tapering actually may actually help the Chinese economy because the exchange rate of RMB have now the pressure to depreciate. Plus, the U.S. economy is going strong, demanding more stuff from China. Number one is anti-corruption. This is hugely popular, and this will pave way for other reforms. Number two is the liberalization of the government functions to allow private business to enter more easily, including demonopolizing some of the state-owned enterprises. The third reform, which is important, is financial reform. We have a timetable of 2 years in liberalizing all the deposit rates, and also 3 years to make the capital account mostly more or less convertible. Not a stimulus package, however, there are reforms which are being implemented in order to prevent the economy from further slowing down, such as a quickened reform to allow private businesses to make investments in certain sectors. And also, some public projects are being moved ahead of timetable to provide certain support for the economy. Yes, certainly. Looking back, there's tremendous important reasons for the QE to be implemented, because QE is like fire fighting. It is emergency measure. Without emergency measure, the fire could have been spread out to other sectors. Well, I think most emerging markets have already developed enough buffer and immune system to deal with the tapering of QE, except for maybe a handful, two or three economies which are in trouble. China is now basically immune from many of the implications of the QE tapering. The tapering of the US policy has implications for investors in Asia to search for new opportunities of fixed income investment projects. Some fixed income investment projects will have to give higher yield to them. So there's a search for high yield products going on. The danger or the pitfalls of the tapering of QE is that some of the products in emerging markets may go through a period of difficulty or distress, maybe even default. Absolutely. Among the major central banks, coordination is very, very important, because these central banks have policies which have impact far beyond their borders. So further coordination is very important, especially considering that the Chinese economy is still growing faster than most developed economies, and the Chinese monetary policy is having increasingly more and more impact outside the Chinese border.